As always, welcome. In this video, we are going to leverage Drupal's configuration API and combine it with the form API. Let's get at it. To make the RSVP list module more useful, let's construct configuration settings for site administrators. This will allow site editors the ability to configure which content types have the RSVP list functionality available. To do this, we are going to leverage the form type of config form base. This type of form allows you to utilize configuration objects in code to communicate with Drupal's configuration, including your module's own configuration if you wish. When using a configuration object, you can leverage the configuration API using get, set, and save methods to handle storage and retrieval of your module settings. Recall that when we developed the RSVP form recently, we used the generic form base class. Note that the config form base, although similar, does have an additional required method called get editable config names. This function is where we will name the configuration settings file to use. It is that settings file that we will apply Drupal's configuration API to. We will use the API to initiate and modify the settings file as needed. To enable this, we will need to create two additional files which will be located in our module's config directory. Let's see this in action now. Have your code editor ready to go with the RSVP list module loaded, of course. Super, let's go. The first thing we are going to do is create the configuration form. In the existing SRC form directory, create a new file called RSVPSettingsForm.php. Notice that the file name is camel cased to match the class name. RSVP, all capitals, capital S, ETTINGS, capital FORM.php. Excellent. As always, at the top of the file, a full PHP tag with the @file doc block. Declare the namespace as Drupal RSVP list form. Next, bring in the functionality we need with these use statements. Begin the class declaration with class RSVP settings form extends config form base. The first method we'll implement is get form ID, returning a form ID of RSVP list underscore admin underscore settings, like so. Next is that additional required method of config form base I mentioned earlier. It's called get editable config names, and it returns an array of the configuration names that will be editable. Nice effort from you. Keep it up. Continue on by implementing the build form method. Remember, this needs to return a renderable array of the form to display. The first line, with the node type getNames function, intuitively returns the node content types currently existing on the site. They are returned as an array of strings of the labels of the content types. We use this types variable as the options in the checkboxes form array below. The next line is important. Let's learn. Config equals this config rsvplist.settings. The config method is a method of the config form base class we are extending. This method retrieves the configuration object named. In our case, we are getting the configuration called rsvplist.settings, which we declared as editable in the get editable config names method above. This variable here called config is a configuration object that we can perform further actions on. If we look within the form RSVP list underscore types variable at the key of default value, we see that we use this config object to further get a data object called allowed types. We have not yet created this allowed types configuration as it requires its own file, which we will create next after completing the code of this form. Great job staying with this explanation. Sequentially, the next step is to declare the form render array elements, which we have already begun exploring. The type of this element is checkboxes, which will list the node content types. It has a title and description to help the site admins understand what actions to take on the form. Awesome! Enough about the RSVP list underscore types variable. A quick point of difference between form types. Notice that for config form based classes, we do not need to declare a submit button in the form render array like we did for the RSVP form class we built earlier. I'll open that rsvpform.php file up quickly to show what I'm talking about. The RSVP form class extends the generic form base, which does not make assumptions about which buttons a form should or should not have. This is why we had to explicitly create a button called RSVP for this RSVP form class. Back here, in the rsvpSettingsForm.php file, this form is extending the form type of config form base. And as such, it does make assumptions about buttons. Namely, by default, the button provided will be a button called save configuration. This is why we do not need to explicitly include a button type in this form render array. Again, super work from you in following along this distinction between form types. Yes! So this brings us to the final line of this build form method. It might seem unique, and it is, for good reason. Type it exactly as shown. Recall that we did not need to include a submit button in this form array. That is true because of this line. Ultimately, we are giving the form and form state variables back to the parent class of config form base for it to do the things it needs to do, including inserting a submit form button into the render array. Awesome work! Continuing on, the final method of this RSVP settings form is the submit form method. Again, let's examine what's happening here so we understand. Essentially, the first line here uses array underscore filter to remove any empty strings from the options the user selected. Ultimately, the selected allowed types variable ends up being initialized to only the choices the form submitter indicated. Then, on the next line, for no other reason than just for fun, we sort the choices alphabetically. On the next line, we begin working with a configuration object again. This line is chained, so multiple operations are occurring with one line of code. I prefer this chaining for code readability. So first, we load the configuration object called rsvplist.settings. Then, we set data called allowed types within the rsvplist.settings configuration. And the final operation of this chain is to save the configuration to Drupal. Again, we have not yet created this rsvplist.settings configuration. We'll do that next. The final line of this submit form method is just parent submit form. No return statement needed because the config form based class will take it from here. Note that although we did not include the validate form method in this code, it could be included if your situation requires it. So this completes the code of RSVP settings form. Awesome! Double check your code and save the file. We will now begin to create the first of two files for establishing the rsvplist.settings configuration. Great work! Let's now create the file which will store the rsvplist.settings configuration data. It is this file that will be used by the configuration API. So, when we use the get, set, and save methods, as we did here in the submit form and build form methods, the configuration API reads and writes this file accordingly. It is important to know that all configuration files belong in a special configuration directory within your module. Let's create it now. In the base directory of RSVP list, create a new directory called config, C-O-N-F-I-G. It is within this directory where further directories can be created depending upon the requirements you are implementing. For us, we want to establish the default configuration which indicates the allowed node content types as the event types that can be RSVP'd to. Make a note that default configuration must be placed in a directory called install within the config directory. So, create another directory with me called install. I-N-S-T-A-L-L. Realize that default module configuration is imported when the module is enabled. This means that once again, we will need to reinstall the RSVP list module. Note that changes to this configuration after a module is already enabled will have no effect. Super, you are doing great. Next, create the file called rsvplist.settings.yaml. rsvplist.settings.yml. Oh yeah. Within this settings file, place the following YAML code. Simple enough. Be sure to pay attention to the indentation spacing of two spaces and only one space between the dash and the text of article. This default configuration will have the effect of having the article content type already selected when a site administrator goes to the RSVP settings form for the very first time. Well done. This completes the rsvplist.settings default configuration file. Be sure to double check your code and then save the file. Let's move on to the final file required for this video, defining the schema of this configuration so Drupal knows exactly how to interact with it. Configuration schema also requires its own directory. Let's create it now. In the RSVP list config directory, create a new directory called schema, S-C-H-E-M-A. In the new schema directory, create a new file called rsvplist.schema.yaml, rsvplist.schema.yml. Excellent. Place the following code. As always, be mindful of spacing. Two-space indentation, and one space after colons if necessary. The top-level key, rsvplist.settings, refers to the base file name of the YAML file we created earlier, rsvplist.settings.yaml, and it also establishes the name of the configuration object. These nested levels describe what is in the file. The first line here tells Drupal that this schema is for the configuration object called rsvplist.settings. It knows it is a configuration object because we explicitly say so here. The label is self-explanatory and could be displayed in situations when exporting or importing site configuration between environments. Mapping is interesting, but mostly straightforward. Essentially, it says that within the rsvplist.settings configuration object, there is data called allowed types, and it is a sequential array with each value being a string. If you're keen to study more information regarding these configuration API concepts, be sure to check out the resources provided at the end of this video. So this completes the coding of this video. Fantastic effort from you. Be sure to double check your code and save the file. Then head over to your site so we can enable this functionality. Great. Let's activate the RSVP list module configuration we just introduced. Remember that changes to the configuration files located in the config directory of our module are only ever imported when the module is enabled. This means what we think it means. We need to uninstall and reinstall the RSVP list module. Let's make a quick list of the things that will be affected by uninstallation. First, the uninstallation is going to remove the RSVP block, so we will need to add it back after installing the module again. Uninstalling is also going to remove any RSVP data in the two database tables, which is fine. We can just re-enter some details as needed in the future. Okay, now that we are aware of the implications of uninstalling RSVP list, let's perform it. Head over to Extend, Uninstall, select RSVP list, uninstall it. It gives us a warning that the RSVP block will be removed, which we were already mentally prepared for. Uninstall. It has been done. Let's quickly reinstall the module before anyone notices. All right, back at extend, the list of modules, finding RSVP list, checking it, clicking install. Nice. Well, this sets us up to add back the RSVP block that was removed. At this point, we cannot actually view the RSVP settings form we defined earlier because we have not yet created a route to it. We will create that route in an upcoming video. For now though, let's add the RSVP block back before we start getting urgent emails about it. Click structure, block layout, scroll down to sidebar first, click place block, find the RSVP block, click place block again, do not change anything, keep all the defaults, save block, scroll down, save blocks. Yes! Let's briefly check to make sure it is still working. Head back to the homepage. As expected, the RSVP block does not show up because the front page is not a node. But if we view the Welcome to Module Development article as before, excellent! Everything is fine. Yahoo! Nice work completing the RSVP settings form and for defining the default configuration for the module. In coming videos, we will begin to really bring this functionality all together by building a route to the settings form and then defining a service which checks to see if the node has been indicated by site editors as an RSVPable event. This is awesome. Again, nice work. Feel free to browse the resources provided to further your understanding. Take a break if you need to. Happy learning.